Welcome to this video, in which I will explain the pre-patellar fascia injury of the knee or cyclist knee. It is a relatively common injury, but unfortunately it is poorly known amongst physiotherapists and doctors. I will explain how it occurs, what the symptoms are, and how it can be treated. Pre-patellar fascia injury is also sometimes called pre-patellar bursitis or pre-patellar fascia defect or pre-patellar friction syndrome. It is caused by a direct hit onto the kneecap, for example, because of a fall onto the front of the knee or because of a forceful hit of the kneecap onto the steering handlebar of the bike. Due to this direct impact, damage occurs to the prepatellar fascia, which can be a contusion or a tear and which can lead to acute or chronic symptoms. The prepatellar fascia is the continuation of the extensor fascia, which runs anteriorly over the quadriceps muscle, over the patella, and over the patellar tendon. At the level of the patella, the prepatellar fascia splits into an anterior and posterior layer, and this split forms the prepatellar bursa. And it is the anterior layer that gets injured or torn by the impact onto the front of the knee. On this picture, you see what happens. The anterior layer gets torn. And what happens then is that each time the knee flexes and extends, the edges of the tear separate and come back, so that the tear cannot heal and becomes a chronic defect. So, repeated flexion extension leads to repeated tear distraction and chronicity. And that is why you see this injury so frequently in sports with high risk for impact onto the kneecap, and where at the same time a lot of repeated flexion extension of the knee occurs, like in cyclists or runners after a fall on their knee, in climbers, but also in judokas and wrestlers who frequently fight on their knees. The symptoms are pain, with or without swelling, and the pain located just underneath the skin, which means superficial to the patellar bone. That is important because of the difference with a cartilage lesion, which can also occur because of a direct impact, but which causes deeper pain. Often, the most tender areas are the supromedial and supralateral quadrant of the patella, because these are the most prominent areas and therefore the most vulnerable to impact. The pain typically gets worse with wearing tight knee pants, when it is cold and wet outside, and during sports activity with repeated flexion extension. Sometimes there is also pain during prolonged knee flexion, for example when sitting for a long time in a low chair, like in the back of the car, or in a cinema chair, or in an airplane chair. And in chronic cases, there may also be a scar on the skin as the witness of a previous impact laceration. The diagnosis can be confirmed by MRI or ultrasound, and especially the cross-section MRI images on T2 sequence are important, because these can clearly show any damage to the prepatellar fascia, like in this case with a large tear and lots of edema on the prepatellar fascia. And also, the MRI is very helpful to exclude any cartilage lesion. As you can see in this case, the cartilage layer is in perfect condition. The treatment in the acute phase just after the injury is to temporarily avoid local contact and impact, and to restrict or reduce provocative activities like repeated flexion extension, so that the tear distraction cannot occur and the lesion can heal. This, together with anti-inflammatory treatment, icings, and local anti-inflammatory or lidocaine patchings. Actually, these patches can also be very helpful in the chronic cases, and they usually are very effective because the injury is located quite superficial and just underneath the skin. So the medication in the patch does not have to penetrate a lot of distance to be already effective. In case the symptoms still persist, sometimes a local infiltration is needed, or even surgery in the more severe cases. During surgery, the torn edges of the lesion are gently debrided until healthy margins are obtained, and then the knee is shortly immobilized so the lesion can fully heal in a couple of weeks' time. So that's it. That's all you have to know about prepatellar fascia injury of the knee, when you have it and what you can do about it. Thank you for your attention.